Hello everyone, today we will see how we can run Python in MATLAB environment and how we can run MATLAB in Python environment, as well as if I have some algorithm in MATLAB, how we can create Python packages and how we can run Python packages in Python environment, so how we can interface that. So first thing which you require, you have to install the Python. So this is the link for that. If you require the link, if you don't know, you can write in a comment, I can provide you that link. Once it is installed, just keep the command here, pyenv. Once you give this command, it shows this some values, this environment variable, these are the environment variables. If showing like this, then it is perfect. If you are getting everything blank, it means you have to set the environment variable for the Python manually for the MATLAB. So for that, what we can do, just simply open the control panel from here. In the control panel, just simply search system, and here is the option, edit the system environment variable, and I will go here in the environment variable. And remember, you can set as a user variable also, system variable. I will prefer that use the system variable. So just I'm going to select the path. I have to set the path for my Python, means the Python which I have installed, what is the path of that. Don't delete or don't modify anything, just click here edit. And there is an option for new, just click on the new. And what environment variable you have to give here, in my case it is this one, Python 20. So my Python is installed here. So let me show you. So you have to give the environment variable, you have to set the environment variable for the Python library. So here I have this Python and this is the lib. Just simply I can copy this from here and I can paste it here. That's all. That then you have to do okay, that's all. So once we have done, restart your MATLAB and just check that environment variable is set or not. So okay, it is set, it's working perfectly. Now in Python there are different way to create variables, like dictionary you can create, tuples you can create, you can create lists also. Let's say if I have to create a list in Python, means how we can create that kind of variables in Python. Okay, so simply let's say I am going to save as a and py dot list, a blank list will be created here. And if I type a dot and if I press the tab, whatever functions are available in Python for the list, it is showing in MATLAB as well. This is the good way to run the Python in the MATLAB, because MATLAB environment is very rich and you can interface very easily, and it will be, everything will be visible for you. So let's say I want to append some value in this list. Let's say I'm going to append 34, and you see that A has a 34. So as we know, in list we can add character, text, integer, anything we can add it. It doesn't matter that what kind of classes I have. Now let's say I'm going to append here, hi, I am using MATLAB. So simply, and if you see, if I type here A, I'd this way we can create the list here. And for the indexing in MATLAB, we know that it doesn't start from the 0, it starts from 1. So this is what is that index number 1, what is that index number 2. And let's say if I want to append list under list, so simply here I can create, let's say 34, 56, 78, 67, just bracket, and you see that I have the list under list also. So if I have to call that list, so simply it is at position number 3, index is 3. This is the way how we can create that. Okay, this is the way. And same way, if you go in the help of Python, just simply type the Python, click here, and lots of helps will be opened, like Python libraries in MATLAB, calling MATLAB from Python, you will get step by step process are given, like in a single line if I have to create the list, how we can create the list. So this options are available here, right? So this kind of things are available here, accessing Python modules from MATLAB and all these things, right? So I am going to show you that things how we can do. Now let's say that if I have to run a Python function, or any kind of function it can be, just I am going to show you a very simple function. I am just using the bracket here, simply function I have created, that is for the odd even. The function, the Python function name is that my func, and if x is divisible by 2 is remainder, sorry, remainder. It is a remainder, it is 0, then print it is an even number, or print it is an odd number. So simply I am going to save this. I have saved on my desktop. So I am going to run this function in MATLAB. So what I will do here, I have these functions, always remember save as .py. And what is the benefit of using this bracket which I has used just now? So it automatically it will take the indent also. So you can also use bracket to write any kind of script for the MATLAB, Python, Java or C++. So I have used the bracket from here. So you can install this bracket things which I have done here. So okay. So this is the bracket. So just if I want that it will take the indent automatically. So what will I do? Just I will create a new from here, new file, and I will save it as .py extension. So automatically, for example, let's say that print is here. If I enter, you see that automatically it is taking the indent, right? Okay, I'm just going to save and close all these things. Okay, now here I'm going to switch the function which I have created. I have pasted here in the MATLAB directory, MATLAB working directory. If I have to run this function, pi dot and the Python file name. So that is myphonecc, right? Myphonecc, okay, and dot. So I can have multiple functions and I can choose any one of them. So right now I have only one function that is called myfunc, right? This is the my function which I am going to execute here. So simply dot. This is the Python script file name and this is the function inside that script file. So let's say I'm going to give value 5 and it's saying it is odd number. So it is working perfectly, right? If I give 34, you see that it's showing it is even. This way we can run any kind of Python functions in MATLAB. The steps already you know. Next, I'm going to show you how we can run MATLAB functions in Python. Or MATLAB in the Python. So for there are some steps which we have to follow. First step which we have to follow, let me show you how to do that. If you have Windows, same way you can use for other operating systems also. First of all, we have to go here for the Windows. So this is the MATLAB root, extern, ingest, and then Python. So let me open this program file and see where I have installed the MATLAB. Simply I will go here, program files, and from here I can search where I have MATLAB here, and this is the directory, root directory of MATLAB where I have installed. I'm going extern, then I have to go here in engine, and here I have the Python. I have to just copy this and I have to open the cmd command prompt. I have to open it as an admin, remember, because we have to set up something, then only we will be able to run that. So cd and this, and now I am in the same directory. The next step is, once I am in the MATLAB root, extern, ingest, Python, then we have to configure something. We have to install this one, python setup.py install. So simply I'm going to run this and you see that everything is done. Now we don't have to do anything, just simply we can open the Python environment and we can open the MATLAB engine and we can execute any kind of functions. So for that we have to open the Python environment. So here this is the cmd again. Just simply I will type Python here. Now you see that I am in a Python environment. The first step is we have to import the MATLAB engine. So this is the function here which you see, import matlab.engine. Just simply I'm going to run here. Okay, it is imported. Now I am going to start that engine. So multiple MATLAB engine we can start here. Okay, so here you see ng is equal to matlab.engine.start. This is the function which we use to start that. Okay, just I'm going here again, switching here, just going to write it now. You see it will take a little time to start MATLAB in Python. Once it is started, we can execute any MATLAB function here in the Python. And from the latest version, you can use this Jupyter also. And once you have Jupyter, you can run your MATLAB functions here also in Jupyter. Okay, just I'm going here. This is started. Now I have MATLAB engine name is ENZ. And whatever function I want to execute, just simply I will type here 0.0 sign files. Why I'm using 0.0 here? Because as a default, MATLAB functions use double precision floating type variable. So in Python, if we have to define the floating type, we have to use decimal, right? So same way, now let's say I want 10 of that, simply it will be executed. Good, so far so good. How we can run? So any kind of functions you can execute here. Now the last one which I am going to show you, how we can create the Python packages from MATLAB functions and we can run in the Python environment. Okay, just simply I'm going to close this and I'm going to switch in MATLAB environment. Okay, a very simple equation I have created, that is called function z dot add dot x comma y, z is equal to x plus y. So any kind of functions you can create, it will be very complicated as well. So just to show you, just I have created very simple. So once this function is created, I have to create one test bench also to execute that functions. Okay, this is my function and this is my script file. Remember, this is a function file, this is a script file. So once I have defined the x value, y value, then here I am going to put z is equal to add x plus y. Let me run this and check if it is working or not. I'm going to switch here. Perfect, it is working and I have the function, and to execute that function I have created one test bench also. Okay, to create a Python package, just I will go in MATLAB environment and from here I will go in this apps. Just below if I go and application deployment, just simply I can open a library compiler from there. One thing remember here, to run Python packages in Python, we require a MATLAB compiler runtime. Okay, so MATLAB, for example, if you run Java program, you require a Java runtime. Same for the MATLAB applications, MATLAB libraries, we require a MATLAB compiler runtime. So MATLAB compiler runtime is free. If you require the link from where to download, just write in a comment and I can provide you that link. So depends on the MATLAB version. Right now I have 2020B release MATLAB, so I have installed this already for that. Okay, now the latest release is, that is R2021A, which was released today itself. Okay, so once we have installed that, that's all you have to do. Only one time you have to install. If you haven't installed, then choose runtime include in the package, so automatically package will be deployed in your app in the package. So I have already installed. So once you will install this, it will be here. So here MATLAB runtime is there. So only one time you have to install. Now what kind of libraries we can create? We can create C library, C++, Excel add-ins also, COM libraries, Java library, .NET. In our case, we have to create the Python package. And here you can provide your name, author name, email, you can provide the icons also. But in our case, we don't require, we provide this informations when we create a matlab.exe file. Okay, so once we have done, it's asking add the exported function, the functions, the add function which we have created here. Okay, done. Now the test bench which we have created, here we have to provide. So here is the option, we can create a new sample test bench. This test bench will be used to execute in the Python. It will tell me that how we are going to execute MATLAB functions. Okay, this is a support file, you may say. So I am going to add existing sample file. So the sample file which I have created, that is sample one, right? If you don't remember, let me show you here again. Here you see, this is a simple one and this is the function to execute that. I have created this test bench. That's all which we had to do, and just package and just save this. I have already created, so I'm going to add this here. Okay, it is still executing. So it will create a binary, then it will create the Python package, then it will save in a folder. So three folders will be saved. I will let you know which folder are you going to use to run in a Python. So this is the way. So it whatever deep learning, machine learning models you have, you can execute in MATLAB. From the MATLAB also, if you have deep machine learning model, you can create packages and you can interface with the Python lab. So it will take a little time to do this task if you are doing the first time. Okay. If you have any query or any questions, you can write me in a chat box. I will let you know. Now you see that binaries are created and these are the folders. So remember, three folders will be created. We are going to use this folder, and you see that this setup.py is again created. We have to run this first, then we can run the MATLAB functions in Python. So if I go in the sample, what you have to do, just copy this sample.py. And what is this sample.py? Let me open it and show you. Just I'm going to open in a notepad. you see that this is the way how we are going to run in Python. So if you want to change the value, so you can use this simple one.py in my case, and you can modify the values to execute that. Okay, here you see that size is also defined. You can modify and execute this Python. So this is a test bench for that. Okay, just I have to copy this and I have to go back and I have to paste it here. That's all which I have to do. And here, simply if I type the cmd, this directive will be automatically added in the cmd. Now you see already same directive we have here. So what we have to do, python, then this setup.py, pi, and install. Once this is installed, you see the configurations are done. Now we can run this function. So how to run this function? Simply type the python and simple one.py, and it will be executed. So first time if I run again, it will take a little time to execute that. So this is the way how we can execute MATLAB function. So let me summarize that. First of all, we saw how to set the environment variable of Python, and you see that we got that value. I want to change this value, just simply I will open this simple.py, and from in any, let's say I am going to open the notepad, and just simply whatever value is there, let's say instead of 5 I am going to use 15, or here 16, and this will be let's say 15, and I am going to save this, and I can open this again and I can execute, and the value will be changed. Okay, let me summarize again. We saw how to install, set the environment variable, how to run MATLAB Python in MATLAB, how we can run MATLAB in the Python, and further we saw that if I have MATLAB function, then how we can create Python packages and how we can run in the Python environment, right? So that's all. Later I will show you, if subscribe the, if you subscribe my video, you will see more advanced, if you subscribe my channel, you will see more advanced functions also. Some also I will like to show how we can interface with Java and some other libraries also. That's very easy to do using the MATLAB. So that's all for today. Thanks everyone.